What's up, everyone? You're watching Tweakly, and about a week ago, I did a video of the always-on display home button to see if it would burn in. I'll leave a link in the description. You can also click the card in the top right corner. Works on mobile, trust me. But anyway, today we're going to see if the home button moves while the phone is actually in use. For example, say you're scrolling through Twitter, or you might be just in the settings app. What would happen if you were to, say, stay in one app with the home button on for about, you know, an hour? So what we're going to do today is I'm going to set the auto lock to 10 minutes, and every 9 minutes I'm going to come back into this room and just touch the screen or move it a bit, just to stop it from going on auto lock. I'm going to set the screen timeout to 10 minutes. And I'm just going to leave it on this page, where, as you can see, we are in the settings app. The home button is displayed at the bottom, along with the back and recents buttons. So if you do what I did, and look really closely at the home button, or even just put your mouse on the corner of it, it does look like that it is moving. However, I did run some simple motion tracking software and concluded that no, the home button is not moving along with the back and recents button. It's just the camera that was moving because I didn't have a very good stand. So basically, Samsung has a very, very big flaw because lots of people are going to be, you know, reading emails. They're going to have to, at some point, stay in the same app. If these three buttons don't move, screen burn-in like this is going to be really, really, really common with the Galaxy S8. Thanks for watching this video on the Samsung Galaxy S8. If you haven't already, be sure to check out my other video in which I turned on the always-on display to see if the home button moved there. Also, remember to subscribe and visit tweakly.net for more cool tech stuff.